was here. Meg was here. Sofie. Sofie.
Hey, Meg. Hey, are you all right?
I don't know.
What's going on?
I didn't think you'd still be here.
Yeah, there was a problem down at the site. What happened? Meg. Paul was here, didn't he? He wanted to talk to you. Did he find you? Did you find Sofie?
What?
This is where you went, right? To find Sofie? Hey, you can talk to me.
I can't.
Why not?
How did this happen?
Work and you don't have to worry about running into me because I won't be there.
Is this a joke?
Nope. I'm done. It's over.
Scully's wasted.
You should be smiling, Allie. Come on. You know, it's what you wanted, right? To my dad and you said, make him leave. So I'm leaving. You know, it's kind of funny, right?
Funny.
Yeah. See, here you are, and you won't have a career in medicine because of me, and I won't have one because of you.
Chris, if you think this is what I wanted, you are so wrong.
Okay, everybody, gather around. It is now time to toast the happy couple.
No, that's Lisa Cricket. I'm so glad you called. I can't believe that you remembered. Yeah, you're right. You know, don't you?
No.
Kitty couldn't make it because she had an appearance in Chicago with Brad. No, Brad.
Mom,
Jack
baby.
Is the cop. The other husband. Never mind. I can't go into it. I love you. Bye, Cricket. Bye.
Oh, goodness. All right. Now, are we ready? Since I am the mother of the groom, I have the honor of raising the first toast to the beautiful couple.
Grandma,
yes,
you're for
I knew you were going to say that. Don't do that. Get away from me. Casey, I'm going to shoot you. Here.
Don't you dare.
Well, one of my kids?
Wait a minute. Now, what can one possibly say about 25 years of marriage, huh? What?
But you say that I was a child bride.
Well, I know, 25 years, this seems like a really long time, but it's really just the blink of an eye. When these two got married, after they got married, I walked down the aisle, I'm sure, at least three times. Let's see, there was Earl. Oh, yeah, and then there was Eduardo. And, oh, and then I had this horrible guy.
Lisa, the toast.
I'm so sorry. It's about you, not me. Okay. To Tom, who truly is the joy and love of my life, and to Margo, his beautiful wife. Oh, you two are simply You're an inspiration. You really are. And I think that you just showed the world that love is the biggest and greatest adventure of all. And I look at you too and I see the definition of soulmates. Oh, these crazy kids, you know, just when they got married, they said, oh, hey, what the, we can do this, it's not hard. And so you just showed everyone, and you fought the fight for love. And I, being a romantic, I think there's nothing sweeter. So to Tom and Margo.
To Tom and Margo.
Hey, don't get carried away now.
Oh, yeah, well, if not now, when?
No, wait. It's your anniversary. And we have a present for you.
Mm-hmm.
You do?
Mm-hmm. All right.
Who has the present for me?
We all chipped in together to give you.
Yes.
You all chipped in to buy one present?
Yes.
You all are so cheap. Yeah. Wow.
Okay, you do the honors then. I have to apologize. Paul's right. I never should have said anything. It wasn't my place. So whatever you're feeling.
I'm not feeling anything. I'm not even supposed to be here.
Where are you supposed to be?
C3A. Flight 117 going to Las Vegas, Nevada. Window seat, so I could see the lights as we landed. We were gonna run off and get married in Vegas. How could I be so wrong about everything?
You weren't wrong, Meg. You just didn't know.
Do you know what I wish?
What's that?
I wish that it wasn't wedding night, so I won't be sitting here in my mother's kitchen thinking about a stupid dress that I'm never gonna wear.